also have something from Singapore here. Also a picture from driver. We're going to talk a little bit about setup and picture our ERP track. The car we're running here is the T4 2017. The car you see right here is my car. It's full of option parts. We'll go through some of the option parts that we run for this particular track. For example, right here, the port that you use the ARS rear suspension. It's a key to a good setup at TRC for the GP track. As you can see, we're running an aluminum rear C-hub to put some weight on the rear axle. That'll make the car a lot more stable off power. We're playing with the shims on the rear suspension to change the balance of the car in the corner. Usually, we end up running 0 or 1 millimeter in this position of the shim link. And a few other things are equally important. We're running a graphite front C-hub, which is a basic option part for asphalt for us. Springs are the hard progressive ones. We're running PSS shock inserts to make the damping more aggressive and give you more grip. We're also running aluminum steering posts in the middle, which will give you more steering lock and make the steering more responsive. There's a few other options on the car which make it easy to use. Adjustable body mount, adjustable battery
holder. 咁就咧呢架就係 Alex 第三年嚟。 呢個香港 AOC 嘅 test， 佢行緊呢架車嘅。咁佢就講下有乜屋頂件為咗呢場嚟設嘅。第一樣嘢佢講就係個ARS，會係ARS啦，有車場。咁就用户一定會用埋呢個鋁嘅絲座。咁就佢就話，因為重啲，比膠重啲，咁就佢後面就多啲重量擲住個尾轆，咁就比有陣時會定啲。 佢哋仲喺度試緊呢個轉向杯嗰個戒指嘅，就試緊10.0咯。碳纖頭絲咗，呢個。彈弓咧就行緊呢個硬啲嘅漸進彈弓，咁就係2.200。裏面咧就行緊係咪呢個漸進筒嘅，轉向筒嘅。仲有呢個鋁嘅轉向水盤，佢就話會多啲睇角。
Covered everything?
Yes. Alright, so I'm gonna explain a bit more about the setup for this track. Because at TRC we have a lot of grip and there's a lot of oil in the surface. So we use a hard dip oil in the rear, usually 10,000 or even harder sometimes. As you know, there's a couple bumps on the track, so you raise up the right height, hold two, 5.2, 5.4. We're playing with the roll center. We add a shim for the bump steer, which is actually 3 millimeter instead of the usual 2 millimeter. You get a bit more mid-corner steering. And yeah, those are the key things for the setup here. I mean, we're also running the optional anti-roll bars, which is 3 in the front and 2 in the rear. That's softer than a kit setting.
咁就佢講解下佢為咗呢場車嘅轉咗嘅 setting 啦。咁就因為佢話有啲凳喎，咁就會車高會升翻點二，比平時行嘅點二係5.2、5.4，同埋呢個bump steer 咧，佢就比平時多1M嘅，平時係2M，而家就3M。 同埋防傾光，佢就揀1.3、1.2。
You wanna explain a bit what you tested on your car throughout the day?
On my car, to help with the bumps, I went to 550 shop on with PSS. Usually I use 450, but the 550 seemed to help me over the bumps, and I raised the downstops. So the whole day I was running 5.646. The last one I tested 6 in front. Seemed to work, but I'm not sure. The 5646 I think especially in the middle, in the center straight, they help to calm the car down over the big bump.
咁啊，呢架就啊，當年架車咧就話，因為場地比較凳就有一有平時就450，而家就550，佢都係行埋嗰個電震筒嘅TSS。咁咧就試緊呢個單縮，平時行5.6、4.6，而家係6.6，5.6。5.6。Now I tested 6 just now，but I'm not sure if it's better。咁咧就試6同埋5.6，佢就唔係太適，未知清楚，咁就再繼續試啦呢個。
Can you explain a bit about the body shell? This right here is a Proform LTCR lightweight. It's mounted quite far to the front. As you can see, there's a lot of leg sun left in the front, so it's pushed forward at least 6 millimeters more than the neutral setting. It has a hard wing on it. We increased downforce, and I also added side stiffeners to make it more stable in high speed. Which is nice in modified racing.
咁佢就講咗佢殼嘅設定啦，咁咧就見到咧呢度咧就剪直好少少嘅，就即係個殼瞓到好似，仲有呢個殼撐就都唔係啲咩新嘢啦，佢話會定啲咯，高速嗰陣時，同埋有呢個嘅Pro-Form嘅硬翼都好硬嘅。
Couple other things on the car which we need to explain. As you can see, we're not running a servo saver, we're running a servo horn to make the steering more direct. In the middle, we're running a carbon center stiffener. So instead of the turnbuckle which comes in the kit, or as is another option, we're running the carbon stiffener in the middle. And this makes the car initially more aggressive, gives it more corner speed, makes it a bit less forgiving.
What's the best thing about that?
What's the best thing?
The best thing before this?
Servo.
Oh, it doesn't run servo saver, because it's straight. So they don't run, so it doesn't matter. 咁就佢哋咧就行呢個中間一條雪條棍嘅碳嘅雪條棍嘅，佢就話有咩用咧？就係第一下轉啲再彎速會高啲，但係就會難揸啲。
Do anyone have any questions at this point？
有冇問題想問啊？
What does he want to know? Like the difference between ARS and standard?
What setting do you
need
here?
The basic setting is no shim here, no shim here. Like zero. But sometimes we get more mid corner steering. We add 1 millimeter shim here. As you can see, I use here 1 millimeter.
Mm-hmm.
When the grip is high, you can use 1 millimeter.
但佢話呢度咬啲，所以就加1M 喺個轉向杯底，咁就彎心會再轉啲。What happens if you add inside?
Add inside?
Yeah.
What happens? Makes the car more stable.
會定啲。如果裡面加架子會定啲。
And another thing which is kind of a fashion thing but actually makes a lot of sense is that we're running a lot of weight in the center line of the car. As you can see here, there's a 20 gram weight right in the middle. There's a battery backstop here, which is 5 or 6 grams, I think.
And what does that do?
Oh my God. Yeah, and as you can see on Dominic's car, he has a insert here in the servo, which is another 5 or 6 grams, plus the battery holder.
What about it?
When you have a lot of weight in the center of the car, actually gives you more traction.
Neutral，咁咧佢就話咧，為咗靚啲啦，可能就中間會加圓，中間呢條線加圓。咁佢話咧，其實除咗靚之外咧，仲有用嘅。佢話架車會咬啲嘅，會易揸啲嘅，平均啲嘅揸起上嚟。
Dominic, your race sometimes was on low traction, right?
Yeah.
Can you explain what is the biggest difference on your setup from low traction to high traction?
Biggest difference for me, I think, shopper. So usually at home I use 450 PSS and softer dip. At home 5 or 6,000. And usually I use the turnbuckle in the middle. Yeah, to generate more traction.
咁啊，Dominic話咧就平時鬥車之前你冇咁跑嘅，咁誒有咩分別咧？就係話有啊有啦，就450，而家就行緊500，誒亞叉就6000，而家10000。Alright,
me and Dominic, we both race modified, and we have quite similar setup, but there are a couple things which are different because we have different driving styles. For example, in my car, I'm running the hard progressive springs. Dominic has decided to use the linear 2.8 spring all around, which makes the car initially less nervous and more forgiving for mid corner, whereas my setup is a bit edgier and harder to drive.
So he just compared two cars, but they have their own style, because Alex uses 2.8
And another difference is I'm running my front arms straight, whereas Dominic has the rear front block higher than the front. And that makes the arm have an angle to give anti-dive, which also makes the car turn initially less, but more from middle to exit.
咁佢就講翻阿Dominic咧，就用呢個潛水啊叫做，咁就第二隻馬就高過前面嗰只，咁就入彎嗰下咧就冇咁反應冇咁快，但係出彎翻身會再轉啲。And
we also prepared a setup sheet to hand out to everybody, which is a good basic setup for this track, which is the setup that I ran yesterday. So you can use this setup, and if you have any questions, come by and we'll try to help you.
咁啊，Alex就預備咗啲設定，就係琴日嘅設定，請你哋拍下，有咩問題可以過嚟問下。誒，咁就有人就問就話。 你嘅幾多錢頭擺位？咁就如果擺前啲咧，就高速彎就再轉啲啦。要install 個 PSS
係咪？要再問 PSS 會唔會轉裝？誒係唔會嘅。PSS has the bigger opening towards the bottom, but it progresses
a lot. 就下邊個窿大過上邊。And
I would not recommend to flip it over.
建議你擺前裝啊。
Do we have any other questions?
In ERS, what's the difference?
Yeah. It's really difficult to say. I mean, normally I would say ARS is suited for a high-speed track with good grip. But lately we've been using it for all that whole track. But for example here, last year, 2 years ago, we ran on that track, we ran the standard rear suspension. Because it was better suited for the tight corners over there. Here, where we have more high-speed corners, the ARS seems to be more
important.
For me, at V-Race, which is a tight track with medium traction, I also use ARS. It's not a CDC, it's a big track, but low grip. So, I use ARS in both cases.
啊，Dominic話佢呢啲race嗰陣時就一個中型啲嘅track都唔係太硬，但都用嘅。It's
really hard to determine with a very track specific. That's the general combo rule, I think.
So you basically you rather track because comfort.
If I have no previous experience with track,
that's the first thing.
Now starting ARS, we race on
asphalt. 就話去到新track咧，第一樣試咧就係 ARS 同埋普通嘅尾盒，就會試 ARS 先。 Because it's like too much.
I think it's more a point of the weight. You have more weight, so that weight can transfer the power from one entry. You get more rear grip of power.
More questions?
Why do you always sim the shop?
Yeah, we get that question a lot, and basically it's because when you shim the shock away from the tower, you create like a leverage, so it actually makes the damping a bit softer, makes the car less edgy, frees it up, and it gives you more body speed, basically. So,
someone asked, 就油壓嘅效果咧會，我覺得接實穩定啲啊，之後易揸啲，冇咁穩定啲啦。
We can explain about the tire prep we use here. You clean the tire before you apply the tire slot. An aggressive cleaner like Acorn tire cleaner or Trinity Red Dot to clean the tire. Right after that, you apply the mighty gripper yellow, the V3, for 10 minutes. And after 5 minutes, you reapply. So you apply 10 times, and for a total time of 10 minutes. That's the best tire prep we've found so far.
Have you applied outside?
I tried applying outside, but I couldn't tell a big difference. Oh, okay. So you're doing it inside.
So he explained this tire 就用比較勁的東西來抹 就用Chui或者Acorn那支銀色橙色罐那支來抹，然後就搽黃蜂B30分鐘。我就問他，因為這冷氣房比較冷，就出來搽，他說試過兩樣都是沒什麼大分別，所以就這樣。你弄啲炸鍋嗎？
I think after half lap you have decent temperature in the tire. It's so hot, the track is so hot. The tire warmer will only overheat the tire more.
More
questions?
Any news about the 2016?
Yes, we're currently testing the 18 version as well. Unfortunately, I cannot tell you what's going to come in the kit, but I can assure you it's going to be bigger updates compared to last year. So there will be two big updates to the car, which I think people will like a lot.
有位朋友仔問，2018有咩變改變咗？Alex就話暫時唔可以公布太多，但係佢話有兩樣嘢嘅大改變嚟嘅。你上年改得多嘢嘅，你一定會中意嘅。不設留意啦。
I know some of you have seen 5 photos online, but I don't know anything about that.
話啲人偷拍咗佢就唔知咩。
我想問一下，如果喺一場個七天制嘅時候，其實會一開始係用啲乜嘢處理方法，即係幫人即係計劃或者處理到去邊啲情況？啊，what setup？Hello, first thing you change is to go to a lighter diffoil, between 6,000 and 8,000 maybe. If it's really low, you can go to a standard rear axle instead of the ARS. You can play with the dip height, you can go a lower dip in the rear for more stability on power. You can add more towing to the rear. Yeah, those are the basic things I would do. I think it's a bit stiffer when you mount from the top.
佢話咁樣比較再扭多少少，比起下邊收粒平扭落。
Traction in the low speed without checks.
Yeah.
can try for the flex setup. You can try this screw hole with a nut on top. And you can try and like loosen the nut like quarter turn or half turn. Sometimes I use that at 50. Sometimes just more for the speed.
Basically,
the kit setting out of the box is a screw with a nut. Not only a screw. That's what the guy drives.
AOS arm, I want to know, do you have graphite or plastic? Any difference?
Always graphite.
Arms, how about arms? Plastic. If you, plastic.
Plastic is more stable. Less corner speed.
What is it?
More stable. More understable.
Because it's too soft.
The thing is, with the X-ray plastic arm, they are much more heavy than the graphite. So it makes the car more stable, more understeering.
One more thing for Binky, usually I think the speed 6 or like the from Protocom or the NASA 2 from Montec gives you more quality. It might not feel better, but I think all the ETS stock drivers feel that it's faster than LTC or IS2 stock. Well,
I'm going to go to the next one.
Thank you.